Hello to everyone, welcome to When in Halifax Mga Cops, and today's discussion is about the 5 things to remember if you are planning to take a student pathway under AIPP. Are you ready? Let's begin. But before we begin, I would like to invite you to join our Facebook group. It's Pinoy Canada Immigration Forum because it's a community that helping each other. So if you have questions, if you have clarification, or you want to share your ideas, your experience, your insights, join Pinoy Canada Immigration Forum because sharing is caring. And again, if this is your first time to watch my channel, I would like to encourage and invite you to subscribe to our channel because we have lots of video about immigration, AIPP, Express Entry, Provincial Nominee here in Nova Scotia. So let's begin, mga cops! So if you are planning to take the AIPP because maybe you already know what is AIPP means, you already know how it works, and you experience how challenging it is to find an designated employer. And maybe right now, you are thinking about student pathway. So we have the 5 reasons or 5 things that you need to remember if you are thinking to undergo under student pathway. So this, the student pathway of AIPP program is also known as Atlantic International Graduate Program. Okay, so the first thing that you need to remember if you are thinking about student pathway under AIPP, the destination province. So since AIPP is about the Atlantic provinces, when you are thinking about student pathway under AIPP, it should be on the 4 provinces of Atlantic. So when we say Atlantic provinces, we are talking about Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, Prince Edward, and Newfoundland. So if you're thinking about AIPP and then your plan is to go to Alberta or to Vancouver, and then AIPP International Graduate is not for you. So if you want to be in AIPP program and you want to take the student pathway, make sure that your school or your institution are in Atlantic provinces, which is the Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, PEI, and Newfoundland. The second thing that you need to remember is the length of education in stay. According to the AIPP eligibility under International Graduate Program, you need to stay in the province at least 2 years program. So you need to have an education here in Atlantic provinces for 2-year course. It can be a degree, a diploma, a certificate, or trade or apprenticeship, as long as you are staying or studying here in Atlantic province for 2 years. So when we say length of education, you have 2 things to remember: 2 years and full-time. It means that you need to be here in Canada, in Atlantic province, especially Atlantic province, you need to be here full-time student. You need to be here a full-time student for 2 years. That's the 2 things that you need to remember: full-time student and 2 years. The third thing that you need to remember is the school should be publicly funded institution. So if you're planning to study here in Atlantic provinces and you are thinking to study on this school, before you enroll, make sure that this institution or school are publicly funded institution. On this video, I'm going to show you all the list of institutions that are public funded institution or institution that are eligible for International Graduate Program. For New Brunswick, if you are planning If you're planning to study at the New Brunswick, there are several schools that are publicly funded. So if you're thinking to study at New Brunswick, make sure that these are the institution. These are your options. College of Communitaire du Nova Brunswick, Maritime College of Forest Technology, Mount Allison University, New Brunswick College of Craft and Design, New Brunswick Community College, St. Thomas University, University de Moncton, University of New Brunswick, and University of New Brunswick, St. Jean. So those are the school in New Brunswick. Let's go now to Newfoundland. If you're thinking to take a student, international student in Newfoundland, there's only two schools, which is the College of North Atlantic and Memorial University of Newfoundland. The second one is the Nova Scotia. The third one is the Nova Scotia. So there are a lot of options compared with the Newfoundland. In Nova Scotia, there are several schools from Cape Breton University. You can choose Dalhousie or Mount St. Vincent, Nova Scotia Art and Design, Nova Scotia Community College, or known also as NSCC, St. Francis Xavier's University, St. Francis University, also known as Centifex, St. Mary's University, University St. Anne, University of King's College. So those are the university, community college that are publicly funded, where they are eligible institution for international graduate program. The last one is the PEI. There are three options: the College d'Ile, Holland College, University of Prince Edward Island. So the fourth thing that you need to remember, if you are thinking about student pathway, you need to be eligible. To be eligible for international graduate, there are two main important that you need to be eligible. The number one is the language test. You need to prove that you are capable to communicate here in Canada. And the language tests that are recognized or used for immigration is IELTS general training, and then the other one is CELPIP. You need also to show that you can support you and your family, because you will be required to get a proof of funds. So if you are not familiar about the proof of funds, I highly recommend to check the description below, because I created a video about the proof of funds for AIPP and also the language test. So you need to be eligible for the language test. There's another question from our kapatid in Halifax. Is, sir, I already have an academic English test or academic IELTS for my university course. Do I need to take a general training for my AIPP application? The answer is yes, because the Canada immigration requirement for IELTS is general training. Some university are requiring academic, but some are just requiring English test. But then, if you are currently holding an academic IELTS, and then you are trying to apply for immigration, the academic that you have right now are not eligible for application, because the required immigration English test or language test is general training IELTS. So unfortunately, if you have a good score in academic IELTS, you need to take a general training. So those are some questions that are commonly questions that we receive. But then let's go for the five things to remember. The last one that you need to remember, it's to get a job offer. So if you are thinking about, okay, I'm already in Atlantic Province and I'm already in Atlantic Province, I'm going to take a two-year course, why do I need to get a job offer? I thought I am in the AIPP program. Why should I, right? So to be eligible for the international graduate program, because they are all this in the umbrella of AIPP, you need also to get a job offer. So even though that you are an international student, you need to get a job offer for one reason. Always remember, the AIPP program is employer driven, means that you need an employer. The advantage of AIPP is your work experience is not required for international graduates hired through the Atlantic Immigration Pilot Program. So let's imagine now you choose to study here in Atlantic Province, and your option, let's say Nova Scotia Community College. You need to stay here for 2 years, you need to study for 2 years, and then after two years, you need to apply for your residency, right? And you can apply it under AIPP. So mostly, if you're an international program, you will have an open work permit. So the best thing is, if you try to study here in Nova Scotia, after your course, you have an open work permit. Try to find a job, and then once you find a job here in Nova Scotia, apply for AIPP, International Graduate Program, and then they are not requiring your work experience. And that's the only advantage of AIGP, or International Graduate Program. So this is also one thing that, in my opinion, the advantage of International Graduate Program, even it's costly. Yes, it's costly because you need to pay. And I already mentioned that the student pathway and the permanent resident visa or pathway is a little bit expensive, because if an international student enrolled here in Canada, they are spending twice the tuition fee of a permanent or citizen here in Canada. So for example, if a permanent resident are planning to study here in Canada, they're already a permanent resident, their tuition fee is the regular price. Commonly in a community college, you're just spending $3,000 for the tuition fee. But for the international student, if you are in the Philippines and you are thinking to study here in Canada, your tuition fee is $10,000 Canadian. I'll post the link on the description below about this information. But the main thing, guys, if you are planning to study here in Canada, I will suggest to try to explore. I am not advising you, because I'm not an immigration consultant, but what I want you to consider these options if you are planning for a student visa. So what I want you to do now is click the link, the description below, and try to weigh everything for you. On this video, I already presented to you the five things that you need to remember if you are planning to take the student pathway. And one thing that I really like about the AIGP, or Atlantic Immigration Graduate Program, is that you are already here in Nova Scotia or Atlantic Province, wherein it's easier for you to find job comparing to finding a job online, comparing when you are submitting a resume or cover letter through Indeed, CareerBeacon, or Job Bank. For me, when you are here, it's easier because employer, they preferred, most of the feedback from our community, from the Wenin Halifax community, most of the employer preferred to hire an applicant that already here in Canada. So AIGP, or Atlantic International Graduate Program, is somehow for me the easier to apply because you are already here in Canada. So that's my opinion. And again, I am not an immigration consultant. The information that I shared to you, mga kaps, are are the information that you can find at canada.ca. So I hope on this video I able to give you insights. I really give you a better options or able to help you for your plan for your family to migrate here in Canada. Please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to share this video to your friends, to your family, and to your groups. If you have groups, please share this video because sharing is caring. Thank you again, guys, and hope to see you again in our next video. Bye-bye.